Hello everyone, hope you all are doing well. Welcome to Diplomat's Desk. I am your host Meet Shah. What if I told you that the world's biggest monopoly is not a single company, but a network of countries, corporations and supply chains quietly building an empire of technology? Everyone talks about NVIDIA's dominance in AI, but few realize that the monopoly goes much deeper. From Taiwan to Netherlands, from Korea to United States, a handful of players now controls how our entire digital world is powered. And the impact is enormous on global economics, geopolitics, especially on India. Let's start with the most visible name, NVIDIA. This single company designs most of the world's advanced AI chips, the kind that power ChatGPT, self-driving cars, and even defense systems. As of 2025, NVIDIA controls nearly 90% of the AI accelerator market. But here is the twist. NVIDIA does not actually manufacture these chips. It only designs them. The real manufacturing power lies with the TSMC, the Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Company. So every time you train an AI model, you are relying on the chips made in Taiwan. Now once the chips is made, it still needs packaging. So here's another choke point. Report says that the NVIDIA has already locked up 70% of TSMC's advanced packaging capacity for its next generation Blackwell GPUs. That means even if the companies design good chips, they may have nowhere to get them packaged. And what about memory? AI chips rely on something called HBM, high bandwidth memory. Guess who controls that? SK Hynix, Micron and Samsung, all from Korea and the US. And almost all of their 2025 capacity is already sold out. No memory, no AI. So we have NVIDIA's designing, TSMC manufacturing and Korean and American firms supplying the memory. Three different nations but all intertwined into one supply chain. That's incredibly hard to replace. But there is a company even more powerful, though most people have never heard of it. It's ASML, based in Netherlands. ASML makes EUV lithography machines, the ultra precise equipment that prints the microscopic circuits on chips. And here's the mind-blowing fact, no one else on earth can make these machines, not even the US or Japan. Each EUV machine costs over $200 million and takes months to assemble. Without ASML, no country can make the most advanced chips, not even NVIDIA or TSMC. So if ASML stops shipping, the world's entire chip industries could slow down overnight. That's how deep this dependency runs. Now let's move from the chips to compute. Even if you somehow make the chips, you still need massive data center to use them, and that's another concentrated space. Today, Amazon, AWS, Microsoft Azure and Google Cloud together control about two-thirds of the global cloud market. Amazon alone is investing over $100 billion a year into data centers. So think about it. NVIDIA sells the chips, TSMC makes them, ASML enables them, and big tech rents them back to you at a price they decide. This is how power concentrates quietly, not by law but by infrastructure. But let's go even deeper into the ground, because to make these chips you need rare earth elements, cobalt, graphite and special magnets. And here China dominates. China controls over 70% of global rare earth mining and nearly 90% of processing and refining. So even if chips are made in Taiwan or US, many of the raw materials still come from China. Recently, China tightened export controls on this material, signaling it knows exactly how valuable its position is. So while the West leads in design and AI software, China still holds the keys to minerals that makes everything possible. This structure creates an incredibly fragile ecosystem. If one country, say Taiwan, Netherlands or China, faces a disruption, the entire world economy could feel it. That's not theory, it's already happening. We've seen GPU shortages, soaring AI training costs and supply bottlenecks that delay innovation by months. Analysts call this concentrated interdependence. It's not a monopoly by law, it's by necessity. And it's rewriting the rules of global trade and diplomacy. Now, where does India fit in this picture? India imported over 18 billion chips last year, most of them made abroad, but that's starting to change. The Tata Group and PSMC from Taiwan are building India's first major semiconductor fab in Dholera, Gujarat. Micron is setting up a massive assembly and testing plant in Sanand, expected to be operational by 2026. At the same time, India's AI mission is planning to deploy 10,000 or more GPUs for public research and startups, a small but critical step toward AI independence. India may not lead the chip design race yet, but it can become the packaging hub, the talent powerhouse, and the trusted alternative in the global supply chain. The strategy is not to outbuild the giants, it is to make the world less dependent on any one monopoly. So who is building the global monopoly in technology? It's not one villain in a boardroom, it's a web of NVIDIA, TSMC, ASML, SK Hynix, Amazon and China, each holding one critical piece of the world's future. And for countries like India, the mission is clear: diversify, collaborate and lead where the world needs balance. Because the next superpower won't be the country that just owns chips, it will be the one who controls how they connect it. If you found this analysis useful, hit subscribe and let's keep decoding the geopolitics of technology altogether. Okay, thanks for watching.